So both teams starting off with their physical lines that like to set the tempo of the game, and we are underway. The first time that the Capitals have ever hosted a Stanley Cup Finals game. Of course, they're in the finals for the first time in the 24-year history of the franchise. Osgood plays it along the boards. Dale Hunter got a body on it. Here's Tenorti from the point. A shot right out on a save by Osgood. And immediately Dale Hunter throws a little snow in the face of the Detroit goaltender. That is not Esatikinen type hockey.
No, it isn't. And he scores that goal in the open net. The game's probably over. Better come back here 1-1.
Here's McCarty. Boy, Tenorti came a long ways across to throw that hit. McCarty a little bit slow to come away. And meanwhile, the other end, Kozak goes by. The puck is a score! The Red Wings around the board. And wait a minute.
Well, Gregson said
Gregson went over, and I think he's indicating it is a goal. It looked like he may have been questioning somebody in the crease. Well, but how about the Red Wings 35 seconds into this game?
The last thing the Caps needed was to have a goal scored on them like this. And what a goofy play this was. Steve Yzerman was involved with it again. Everybody was watching Tenorti hit McCarty over by the Red Wing bench. And then Yzerman went the other way. He got outside. He beats Tekin into the outside. He can't control him. He ends up hauling him down. There's a delayed penalty in progress. Loose puck. Everybody's standing around. And Thomas Holmstrom got to the open puck before Todd Krieger. And the Red Wings are on the board just like that.
Big goal in the third period of game two and set up the winning goal in overtime. Sednik, a steal by Shanahan. Larry Murphy straight away a drive. Kolzig the save. And he hangs on. And immediately Lapointe throws some snow in the face of Olaf Kolzig. Just like Dale Hunter did at the other end to Chris Osgood.
Turnabout is fair play, says Lapointe.
Here comes Joe Koser the other way. Three Red Wings on the attack. Koser tried to slide it through. And we have a whistle on the play. Simon with a hit on Malfi, I believe, after the whistle.
And Hunter gives Malfi a high elbow. And I don't know who the penalty is going to be on to start with, but the Washington Caps losing control.
And that came back to haunt them for a while as the Capitals scored three goals in the second period. Housley tried to clear it, is blocked by Lapointe. His centering pass in front, a chance here. Kolzig, a great stop there on Doug Brown, who tried to go high.
Detroit's had too much to say about that, Dave.
Well, in the six periods in Detroit, here's a chance for Kozloff. He's onside. He moves in, shoots. Oh, and Kolzig a save. He got a piece of it. Olaf Kolzig with a huge save here in game three.
Kolzig got the blocker on it, though, and later delivers an elbow to the left ear of Sergei Fedorov.
Manatsnikonov and Vladimir Konstantinov recovering from that horrible limousine accident, which, ironically, 1 year ago tonight. 1-0 is our score here as McCarty, a collision with Berube, and a big hit by Dale Hunter on Fedorov, and it's going to be a charging call
from behind.
Dale Hunter giving it to Sergei Fedorov for going down on the hit. Sends it deep. Kozloff has it there. Here is Larionov. Drives the shot right through the save by Kolzig. Scotty Bowman with Kozloff out there for a chance and a right pass. Saved by Kolzig. Loose puck, and finally the Capitals get to it. And Erickson dumps it deep into the Capitals zone. Housley hit hard by Malfi.
Housley's going to go for a high stick. Boy, they are going to be ugly about this. Draper went to deliver the hit, and Housley got the stick and the elbow up. Watch this.
Here is Murphy. Drives the shot just wide of Kolzig. Penalty coming against Detroit, I believe. Yes, it'll be Holmstrom, I believe, for goaltender interference.
Yes, indeed. He was in the crease.
He's going to say he was pushed in there.
Well, he was getting worked over pretty good by Gonchar.
Well, they chop it back to the line. McCowan drives the shot. Kolzig the save, and the puck up into the crowd. Into a group of Red Wing fans here at the FCI Center.
Well, there's enough of them around here, boy, with their reds and white jerseys on all over the city of Washington this week. This building is sold out.
Well, I think
that is what they call a wing nut.
Right.
Hat. Isn't that amazing? One chance they get to have a good scoring chance, it goes by the board.
Is the reason most coaches like to start on the road.
Gee, look out.
Big collision there as Malfi went flying. Coaches worry in pressure-filled games how their team's going to react in front of their home fans. Caps get there and clear it off the glass. Bob Rouse took a slash but got a piece of the puck to hold it in. Hunter drilled by Martin Lapointe.
There's Hunter. Now he's after the referee that there should have been a charging call there. He's the only American-born player on the Red Wing team. And he takes some pretty good-natured ribbon about that, of course, being here in Washington.
Rouse with a shot and a save and a rebound in the glove of Posey. And that was Holmstrom that actually pushed the Washington player into Olaf Kolzig, and is Holmstrom going to get a penalty for that, or are the Capitals going to get all the Caps, I think?
Krieger's the guy that he got off balance, and Holmstrom gave him a timely shove.
We are early in the second period. Here's a steal by the Capitals. Tinkin to put it right on goal. Bouncing puck out, it's going to come to the line. Rinkie with a tip. Oh, and it's good! Able to reach back and stop that puck that was rolling toward an empty net as the Capitals finally got a second shot on goal.
That puck rolling slowly towards the net. I think it would have gone in, but Osgood got there just in time. Oh, boy.
He does it without a lot of fanfare, too. Here is Zednik, one-on-one against Erickson. Zednik gets the shot away, and Osgood the stop. Juno out to the line. Gonchar mishandles the puck and bounces out to center right. Well, those are accidents that can happen to anybody, but the Caps can't afford it. Here's Juno on the rush. Makes a great move. Bellows the shot. Save. Rebound is loose. Osgood was out of the net, but the Red Wings get to it. They fail to clear. Oates drops it back to Housley. He sends it in deep. Bellows looking to the front of the net, and Osgood has it on the glove. Puts it in deep. McCowan hammers it along the boards. It comes loose. Oates. Oh, what did that hit? Did Osgood get a piece of that? And then maybe it got up to the crossbar. I think he got his shoulder on it. Whoa, what a chance there for the Washington Capitals. It'll come down on the ice, recovered by Bellows. Back to the line, Gonchar. His pass intercepted, but Oates hands it off. Housley a chance off the glove of Osgood behind the net. Hunter drives it along the boards in behind Osgood. He stops it there. Bob Rouse will lead it. Oh, Rouse was drilled to the board by three different Washington Capitals.
Wow.
And he's going to get up and skate back into the play. Those are the two main guys in there. Zednik trying to get the speed going. He was slowed down a bit. Gets to the puck. Centering pass. What a stop by Osgood. On Bondra.
Wow.
Oh, the great speed of Zednik. The gate of the icing. And then Bondra with a great chance. Murphy tries to clear. Klee held it in. Now it's knocked away. Doug Brown, a lead pass for Igor Larionov. He drives the shot. Kolzig squeezes the pads together and makes the save.
They go.
And it's out to center ice. Could be a 3-on-1 for Detroit. Eiserman with the puck. McCarty on the far side. Eiserman shoots. Save made by Kolzig. And he covers up Steve Yzerman. Tried to beat Olaf Kolzig in the same place he did on a similar chance in game two.
What a wonderful player, and a big plus he has been at playoff time for the Detroit Red Wings.
To the net, deflected in front. Kolzig juggled for a moment. That makes the save, and I'm not sure who the Red Wing player is.
Draper.
It was roughed up in front,
that's
but he
Draper.
Went right back at Gonchar.
Yes, it's Chris Draper who drilled Gonchar over top of Kolzig, and Kolzig for the first time in this series beginning to show some emotion. He's had a history when he was younger of being involved emotionally and getting off his game because of it.
Shanahan looking to go one-on-one against Gonchar. Shanahan between the circles, trying to get a stick at it. Loose puck, two Red Wings overskated back to the Capitals. Could be a two-on-one, Bondra and Zednik. Only one back is Erickson. Bondra, the drive, a save by Osgood.
Oh, my, oh, my. Bondra again. Oh, my. Detroit makes maybe their second mistake in the game.
Just wasn't comfortable in games like this. He changed them. Here is Yzerman. One hands it toward Kolzig. Oh, that took a strange hop. Off the crossbar in the post, I think. It stayed out of there. Here comes Oates on a three-man rush for the Capitals the other way. He leads it for Juno. Juno, tough angle, trying to sweep it in front. Loose puck is picked up by McCarty.
See who made the play coming back? Number 19.
Larionov's pass broken up by Tiikkanen. Tiikkanen. Starts it back the other way. It'll be broken up by Murphy. Bouncing puck. Murphy picks it up and injured at center ice.
Yzerman got blue-footed, I think, by Asa Tiikkanen. He really went down hard, big time. Oh, did he ever give it to Yzerman.
Back the other way, Fedorov one-on-one against Reiki. Fedorov drives a shot and broke his stick.
Another stick. Another broken stick for Fedorov. He's at 15 of them in these three games so far.
Here is Oates, tries to make a move, going to the net! Save made Osgood on the puck steered aside. Here is Oates one more time. Centering pass. Juneau, though, was checked on the play. Larry Murphy in traffic somehow with the presence of mind to clear it at the board. Send it deep for Brendan Shanahan. Shanahan, nifty move behind the net against Housley. Centering pass. Loose puck at the side of the net. Kolzig had the right pad on the ice and kept it out of there. Batishoff to Lariana. He drives the shot, and Kolzig had a good view of that one. Here comes Koster looking for a hit on Klee. Hits him up against the board. Ooh, a hit from behind by Simon, and he did get away with one there. Pass up the middle, intercepted by Tiikkanen. Tiikkanen drives the shot that was blocked by Batishoff. Here's Krieger with it. Now for Dale Hunter. Centering pass. Gonchar missed the net. He hits him room high on the glove side. Back to get it now for the Capitals. Nuno to Adam Oates. Off his skate, didn't come out of the zone. Kolzig a save. Loose puck is here. He has to make another stop on Draper. Lead pass for Juneau. Juneau is checked on the play. Gonchar gains the zone. It's knocked away, and it's out to center right, but there's going to be a penalty. Darren McCarty.
Almost a minute into this one without a shot.
Housley drives it in wide. Malpe fans on it. Fellows tries to hand it off for Juneau. He's chasing after it. Juneau pressured right away out near the line. Rolls it back. They get it to Adam Oates. Oates trying to cut out in front. It's off a Red Wing. Loose in the crease. They score!
Ryan Bellows.
It's a goal! Power play goal for the Washington Capitals to tie the game.
Ryan Bellows found the loose puck. As the Caps finally get the break they needed on the power play with Darren McCarty off.
Batishoff with it. Flips it out center ice. Sednik is there. Red Wings were making a change. Kozlov tried to drag that loose puck. It is picked up now by Fedorov. Fedorov drives the shot. Kolzig save. Rebound! Fedorov. Kolzig stopped that one. Puck still loose in the capital zone.
Now it was Sergei Fedorov that last shift. He took it over by himself and forced Kolzig to make two good stops. Stay alive, basically, and hope to fight another day.
Brown checked by Tenorti. Chris Simon, number 17 for the Capitals there as well. Now Dale Hunter into the fight. It goes back to the line. Tiikkanen had the stick ready. Now it comes toward the Detroit net. Batishoff clears it off the board. Cleared ahead by Brown. Fedorov is onside. Fedorov against Johansson. Gets the shot. Oh, he scores! Sergei Fedorov! Oh. He did use the defenseman as a screen and beat Oleg Kolzig to give the Red Wings a 2-1 lead.
What a move by Fedorov. Well, we talked earlier in the show about Fedorov with 13 shots on goal in game two and nothing to show for it. My goodness. He turned Kalle Johansson inside out right here. Doug Brown makes the play off the boards. Fedorov waits for it to be onside. Watch him. Moves it inside the stick and then quickly beats Kolzig to the short side over the catching glove. Under the heel, in front of the skates, boom! 2-1 Detroit, just like that. Lightning bolts have been in Washington area all day, and another one just struck. And maybe the last one they need to see.
Sergei Fedorov's first goal of these playoffs. The 10th goal, or first goal of this series, I should say, his 10th goal of the playoffs. Sends it in deep. Back to get it is McCowan. McCowan moves it for Lariana. It is chipped by Shanahan, but not out of the zone. Picked up by McCowan. He will clear. Red Wings glance up at the clock and take a look. Here's McCowan. It is blocked by Juneau in the neutral zone. Down to 20 seconds. Gonchar with it. Center ice. They try to get it into the wing zone. It hits a lineman. Fedorov plays it across. It is gloved down by Juneau. Picked up by Adam Oates. He'll drop it back to Gonchar. 10 seconds left. Gonchar's pass hit a skate. He'll try it again. It comes into the Detroit zone. It's off the stick of Juneau. Bellows pinned to the boards. And that is it. Sergei Fedorov's dramatic goal late in the third period will be the game winner. And the Red Wings have a stranglehold on the 1998 Stanley Cup Finals.
Now Peter Bondra with a stick up on Bob Rose right at the end of the game. Obviously some frustration there. The Washington Capitals in the last minute of play with Kolzig on the bench could not get the puck over the Red Wing blue line with possession and control purely because of Detroit's hard work defensively. Boy, oh boy. This hockey game ends up a 2-1 game. And Red Wings outshoot the Capitals 20 or 34 to 18, as it turns out, almost 2-1 again.
And they outshoot them 10-5 in the third period. The Capitals did have a slight advantage in shots in the second period, but again, when it counts most, they got somebody steps up.
Yeah, they've got just too many weapons for Washington to be able to deal with.